The Buckeyes, one of three Big Ten teams in the top 10 alongside Wisconsin and Penn State. But for the third straight year, Alabama begins the season as the top-ranked team. Your defending champs fall by Clemson and Georgia. Just outside the top 10, Michigan State at 11 and Michigan at 15. Big Ten East very well could be the toughest division in the nation. Rob, your alma mater, are they the best in the East? Are they the best in the Big Ten?
I think that they're the best in the East and the best in the Big Ten. You look at the change at quarterback, obviously, Dwayne Haskins, he did a tremendous job stepping into that offense in a win in a hostile environment on the road at Michigan. He's got two great running backs, some faces to replace on the defense, but we've seen time and time again with the recruiting that Ohio State has done that they're going to be able to roll some new guys in there. Now, I do look in the East, the competition, I believe, is going to come from Michigan. Bringing Shea Patterson into that offense this year, I think, makes a tremendous difference in this Jim Harbaugh offense. And we know on the defensive side of the ball, Don Brown, Dr. Blitz, he's done a tremendous job with the defense, and he has got some great pieces on that defense. Chase Winovich on one side on the defensive end, and then you have Rashawn Gary on the other side, Devin Bush at linebacker. Those guys are going to be tremendous. And with that missing piece, the missing piece finally in that offense, with a great quarterback, Michigan could be dangerous, but they're still the second best in the East to me.
I agree with you. I think Ohio State is the team to beat, not in the Big Ten Conference. You know, we'll get there later, but in the Big Ten East. And for reasons you mentioned about the quarterback, Dwayne Haskins, first of all, JT Barrett, coach, your guy.
My guy.
Was a winner. He was a leader. He was a competitor. Really did a great job in college. But this kid, and we saw in a small sample size last year, but he played extremely well in a hostile environment. He's big. He can throw the football downfield. And it's very similar to Cardale Jones a couple years ago when JT Barrett got hurt. He came in, and that offense looked completely different with the ability to attack the back four, attack the secondary. You combine that with J.K. Dobbins, a great offensive line, really talented guys on the outside. This is a scary, explosive offense with Dwayne Haskins, and we'll see how he develops this year.
Yeah, there's no question he has the talent. I'm from a coach's perspective, look at Urban's history. Two quick points. One, everywhere he's been, Alex Smith at Utah, when he had Tebow at Florida, obviously we talked about JT, he always has a quarterback when the game's on the line, critical play, that will get the snap, protect the football, and make a play with his feet. You know, how is he going to adjust and loosen things up to take advantage of Haskins' skills?
And what was interesting is that when that was taken away from him, they played their best football in his era at Ohio State and won a national championship. So there's an argument to be made. They might even be better this year than they were in previous years. But, Robert, I'm with you on Michigan. I think Michigan could have one heck of a football team. First of all, they're the team that everybody loves to take shots at because their head coach, Jim Harbaugh, has put himself out there so often. But the fact remains, they're going to have a top five defense in college football. They've got a great stable of running backs, very good pass catchers on the outside. If they can clean up their offensive tackle position, Shea Patterson may be the difference. And then getting over that hump and winning a division and potentially winning the Big Ten, that's a team that I'm very high on.
Penn State.